Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1690, total 830 to 5. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Leslie. Leslie has entered the schedule here for the week, 830 to 4, 430 to 10, 30 off, 5 to 10. Wants to know how to total it. Right? It sounds so simple. How do we total it? And initially I'm like, oh no, you can't do that, or maybe you can do that with VBA, but then I started thinking about it, well, you know, it's complicated, but we can do it. If there's no dash off and vacation, then the hours are zero. If there is a dash, we have to break the cell into the start time and the end time, so we can split that. If the start is greater than two digits, then we know that there's minutes, 8:30, 10:30. So that's if we have three or four digits, we have to deal with those minutes. Take the minutes, separate them out, divide by 60, and then add to the hours. And then we also have this one. Once we get this, so let's say we convert this to 4.5 and 10.5, but there was a day where Leslie worked from maybe 10:30 to 5, where the end time is less than, well, here, this one, 8:34, perfect. So once we get the start and end, if the end is earlier than the start, we have to add 12 to the end, finally do the subtraction, and then add the whole thing up. You know we're in trouble if it took a minute 26 just to explain what we're going to do. So first, do we have a dash? Equal find the dash in this cell. And that's going to tell us the position of the dashes, which is going to be very, very helpful. See those value errors though. So if there is no dash, we're going to get an error, which we can actually use to our advantage. All right, so the start as text. Well, we want the equal left of this cell, comma, this number, because the dash is in the fourth cell, minus 1. All right, so that gives us 8:30. But we're going to get values over here. But what I had said was if there's no dash, we're going to use a zero. So we're going to say equal if error. If that gives us a error, then just assume the start time is zero. All right, good there. So we handled the dash. And then I need to get the end as text. All right. So that's equal mid of this entry up here, comma. We want to start at the dash plus 1. And then we want to, how many characters do we want to get? Well, we want to get the length of B2 minus where the dash is. And that should get us, in that case, 4. Oh, of course, we're going to need the if error here as well. So let me just put that in before I copy across. If there is no dash, then the end time is 0. All right, so we now have start, 8:30, end. We need to figure out if we have minutes or not. So let's do start as hours. All right, so equal if the length of this answer is greater than 2, then we know that we have minutes. We want to take the right of this answer, comma 2, divided by 60 to convert those minutes back to hours. And we want to add that to the hours, so that's the left of B4 comma the length of B4 minus 2. All right, so that's if we have 8:30, three digits or four digits. If we just have one or two digits, then we just want the answer, which will be B4 plus 0, and that'll convert it to hours. Boy, if that works, that's going to be amazing. All right, start as hours. There we go. Yeah, good. All right, end is hours. Well, this one's actually going to be simple. It's just going to copy the formula from above, Control C, Control V. All right, and then we need to adjust the end. Equal if the start is greater than the end, then 12, otherwise 0, plus the end. And then finally we have hours today is equal to end minus start, Control V, copy across. See, then I already have my equal sum function up here, equal sum to sum everything up. So let's just try it. So instead of being off on Wednesday, let's say you went in for 2 hours, you worked from 11 to 1. course, have to enter an apostrophe before that or convert these to text. 11 to 1 should go from 18 and a half to 20 and a half. Hey, all right, looks like it is working. Let's see if we can do something really bizarre like 11:15 to 1:30. No colon, no colon, no colon. 11:15-1:30. 20.75. Okay, good. See, now that's really important that you make sure not to enter the colon there. You know, all these formulas are set up assuming that you're going to follow the same rules that you initially did. Let's convert these to text to make life a little bit easier. There's some times that will look like a date, like 5 to 1 will look like a date. So we'll explicitly choose text there. That way, even if I enter 5-11. That will not get converted to a date. Well, there you go. It sounded like a really, really simple problem. In the end, we ended up using how many functions? Sum, find, if error, left, mid, len, and right. 7 different functions, and in my case, 36 different formulas to answer that one simple question. Of course, if Mike Gervin Excel is fun, we'll probably pop in here with some array formula that can solve this in one cell, but that's Mike. You know, he's the author of the best-selling array formula book on the planet. So there you have it. Leslie, thanks for sending that question in. No, wait, don't close it yet. There's another way to do this. So this is kind of a dueling Excel podcast with Mr. Excel versus Mr. Excel. Well, I was waiting for the other part to render. I just said, well, you know, I wonder if we can shorten those 35 formulas down. And we can. We can combine all of the formulas in that Monday column into a single big long formula, which I'll put on the call out there. And then you could copy those going across. That way we could actually realistically have one row for every week, you know, all the weeks, and have a total here. If you don't want anyone to see these columns out here, you can right click and hide, and it would actually realistically work. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another night.